Hi, I'm Andrew Joseph Keith, and this is the Proko Figure Sculpting Fundamentals course. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to capture gesture using your wire armatures. I will be using some small wire armatures, some Chavant NSP medium clay, and the reference photos provided by PoseSpace.com, which you can find in the link below. If you haven't already seen the lesson on how to build wire armatures for sculpture, be sure to check that out. And it will also help if you've seen the Proko lesson on drawing gesture. I will be using these small wire armatures without a stand. Even if you're using another type of armature, you should be able to apply these principles to capture any given pose. What's nice about starting with our homemade wire armatures is that we already have all of the proportions in place right from the start. Now, all of the elements may be the right length, but without the gesture, we won't be able to capture that lifelike feeling of the pose. Like with drawing, as we develop the details, the pose often becomes more stiff. This is why it's so important to first capture gesture before we start to think about the details. If we're able to capture the gesture so that it feels natural, and we already have all the proportions in place in the armature, then the sculpture is already half done. All that's missing is the clay. Whether you're sculpting from a live model or from photos, a great habit to get into is to strike the pose yourself. As we make the pose, we will gain an understanding of it that is difficult to obtain by visual observation alone. We'll get a sense of where the weight of the body falls and how the body is balanced. Pay attention to how your head, rib cage, and pelvis relate to one another in the pose. We want to pose the armature to create an extremely expressive figure before we begin to add clay. Once the armature is encumbered by clay, it becomes more time-consuming to make big changes in the gesture. In my opinion, it's better to push the gesture just a little bit further than reality, because I think it's better to have too much gesture than too little. When looking for the gesture, we should first try to see the relationship between the three primary masses of the body: the head, the rib cage, and the pelvis. Is the upper body twisting? Is there elements of contrapposto that brings one side of the pelvis up and the same side of the shoulder down? At what angles do the arms come off the figure? What about the legs? Gesture of illustrating the relationship between George Bridgman does an amazing job of illustrating the relationship between gesture and structure in his drawings. He's able to use these masses to push the gesture and create extremely dynamic figures that feel sculpted from blocks. Once you feel like you have an understanding of the pose, start by focusing on the angles of the head, the rib cage, and the pelvis from the front view, including the bend of the spine. Once I'm comfortable with the trunk of the body and how the primary masses relate to one another, I will try to capture the angles of the limbs and how they extend from the torso, the upper arm and upper legs, again starting with the front view, then moving to the side view, then repeating the process for the lower arms and lower legs, then finally focusing on the position of the hands and the feet. When capturing the gesture of a standing figure, an important element is balance. If the figure is unbalanced, it will feel like something is off, and the figure needs to be balanced from every angle. Imbalance can be used to get the feeling of motion or instability. If you took a snapshot of a sprinter, it would look like they're falling forward, because they kind of are. An understanding of balance can help our figures have the feeling of movement or stability. To help us know if the figure is balanced, we can draw an imaginary plumb line through the center of mass of the body, down to the feet. When one foot is more load-bearing, the center of mass will fall on or near that foot. We can do this from every angle to check where the center of mass is in relationship to the feet. With these small gesture studies, I don't have to worry about the balance until the end, when I place it on a base with some clay. But if this were a larger sculpture, I'd want to pay attention to the balance from the very beginning as I'm posing the armature. Try to add gesture throughout the figure. Look for S and C curves that connect the elements. The leg from the side will often have an S curve that bows forward in the upper leg and slightly backward in the lower leg. When at rest, the spine has a significant S curve to it that can be captured with the armature. When we start building out the clay, we want the wire to be in the center of the forms whenever possible. This means our armature should be more gestural than the skeleton would be. There are many areas of the body where the bones are extremely close to the surface, like your shin bone. If the armature is too close to the surface, we might run into it later on. To avoid this, we should follow the center of mass of the forms, which tend to be more gestural, especially in the extremities. When bending the wire at the joints, be sure to keep the measurements accurate. We don't want to capture the gesture at the expense of the proportions that we've already established. Be precise when bending the joints so you don't lose exactly where the joint should be as you begin to add clay. We can do this by using a tool to clamp the wire tightly or by pinching it with our thumbnail to create a sharp, precise angle. If you only have a single photo reference to work from, try to imagine how the figure exists in 3D. Consider what it might look like from every angle. You can even try capturing the gesture with the Skelly app and then recapture it with your wire armature. If you have a live model or a friend that can strike a pose for you, you can actually hold the wire armature directly up to the model to help you see if you've correctly represented the pose. Something I do all the time is photograph the armature close to the same angle and perspective as my reference photos of the model, and use a transparent overlay to combine the images to check the pose. This isn't a perfect system, as there is almost always a difference in the perspective or the angle of the shot, but it can help get a rough estimate. While checking the pose, there will almost always be some element that's slightly off, so make those small adjustments to capture the pose. Once we've captured the gesture with the armature, we can add clay to build out the mass of the figure. We will go over how to build out our sculptures with clay in a future lesson, but for now, just add some clay to get a sense of the mass while focusing primarily on gesture. Don't get caught up in the details. Your assignment is to do 1 to 3 gesture studies using the photos from the link below. These photos were provided by posespace.com, which has the uncensored, high-resolution versions of these and other poses that can be purchased on their website. They also have a free pose tool that lets you view low-resolution images of their poses. These low-resolution photos work great for small, simple gesture studies like this, or you can use your own photos or a friend as a reference. You can upload your assignments to social media using the hashtag ProcoSculpture. If you have any questions, you can find me on Instagram at Andrew Joseph Keith. Be sure to check out the premium course, where we will be practicing capturing gesture from master studies like those of Stan Prokopenko. Have you heard of him? As well as George Bridgman and others. We'll also go more in depth on different types of common poses used by artists and sculptors throughout history. There are additional demos, 3D models, tips, in-depth videos, assignment examples, and much more, so go check it out at proco.com/sculpture.